A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th Feb, on the front page you have women army officers eligible for permanent commission, Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has dismissed the union government's submission that women are physiologically weaker than men as a sex stereotype and declared that short service commission SSC women officers are eligible for permanent commission and command posts in the army irrespective of their years of service. Then here you have Shine Bag, protest but don't block roads, court tells protesters. So Supreme Court has conceded that mothers, children and ordinary people of Shine Bag in Delhi had a right to protest against the Citizenship Amendment Act, even as it expressed concern over the blocking of public areas. So a senior advocate has also been appointed as interlocutor in the case. Here you can see. There's another advocate along with him. Two advocates have been appointed as interlocutors to convey the Supreme Court's apprehension to the protesters and suggest to them to move to an area where they could continue the protest but not inconvenience public movement. Then below you have fresh death warrant issued for March 3 in Nirbhaya case. So in the Nirbhaya case, now Delhi court has issued fresh death warrants. Now the hanging would take place of all four convicts on 3rd March at 6 a.m. They were given time to exhaust all their mercy petitions and pleas, review petitions which they wanted. Still the advocate on behalf of the convicts is highlighting how earlier mercy petition was not completely detailed and fresh mercy petition is proposed to be filed before the president by him now. And this is UK leader denied entry, deported. So this is a member of parliament from UK, Labour MP. He was deported to Dubai as she was found not in possession of a valid Indian visa. So her name is Debbie Abrahams. On page 9 you have India's bird population suffers long-term decline. So this is a joint study conducted by 10 bodies which blames growing threat from loss of habitat, widespread presence of toxins, hunting and trapping as the major reasons for India's bird population declining. So this is Nilgiri pipit, which is a species of high conservation concern, currently suffering a decline. Here you can see, it said 1/5 of India's bird diversity, ranging from short-toed snake, eagle to sirkir malhoka, have suffered strong long-term declines over a 25-year period. Some have seen annual trends point to a drastic 80% loss among several common birds. So this is State of India Birds 2020 assessment. Then below you have Peninsula Command by next year end, says General Rawat. So, Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat has spelled out a roadmap for restructuring the armed forces that would holistically counter threats along the border with China and Pakistan as well as in the Indian Ocean. So, there will be logistical agreements with other countries to put this into effect. Then this is Government plans research on indigenous cows. So government has unveiled a program to research on indigenous cows. This will be funded by multiple scientific ministries and the initiative is called Sutra Pik. So it is led by Department of Science and Technology. So here you can see various ministries in the departments involved are Department of Biotechnology, CSIR, Ministry of Ayush, etc. So it's Sutra means scientific utilization through research augmentation, prime products from indigenous cows. It has five themes: uniqueness of indigenous cows, prime products from indigenous cows for medicine and health, prime products from indigenous cows for agricultural application, then for food and nutrition, then for cow based utility items, etc. So these are the five major actual themes under Sutra Pik. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a royal mess. So this is regarding how in October 2019, the Supreme Court gave a verdict on adjusted gross revenues and asked the telecom companies to pay up to the government, pay up to Department of IT. And later we saw Department of Telecom giving an order saying that if they, and the deadline given by the Supreme Court was of 3 months. So if beyond 3 months and the telecom companies did not pay, the government official said that from Department of Telecom that no adverse action should be taken or adverse note be made. So this has been taken down strongly by Supreme Court. It has called it contempt of court, trying to sidestep the judicial pronouncement. So this is called a royal mess. And it says only pragmatism and prudence can lift the telecom industry from its current trouble. Of course, telecom industry is in stress and paying up, like is difficult for them. But then Supreme Court order has to be implemented, and Bharti Airtel actually paid up 10,000 crore on Monday and said it would pay up, you know, the remaining amount. And this is Women at Arms. So this is regarding the front page news today, that a woman permanent commission have been allowed by the Supreme Court. It has demolished gender stereotypes. The lead article is India's disturbing trauma narrative. So this is regarding how silence over violence being perpetrated against children has resulted in country to appear to having lost its moral compass. This is how children suffer, and then when they come out and detail out about their trauma, it is highly disturbing. And this is the long and short of Trump versus the rest. So this is regarding US politics now. So Trump of the Republican Party has his complete party supporting him. The Republican Party is behind Trump, and US president is going all out to back the November presidential elections. Then on op-ed page you have protecting children's right to protest. So this had become an issue. National Commission for Protection of Child Rights had also been involved. It spoke about how children are suffering in the protests, and it was talking of counseling them as such. So then it has been highlighted even in the UN, under the UN Convention on Human Rights, it clearly states that children have a right to protest. We are seeing even protests by children against climate change. So protests by them, they also have a right to voice themselves. So this article says a child has as much right to be present at a protest site as any adult. And this is, may the force be strengthened. So this is regarding CRPF, that is Central Reserve Police Force. So the functioning of CRPF needs to be revitalized, is highlighted here. So the entire history of CRPF, it was earlier called Crown Representative Police, CRP, which was later renamed as Central Reserve Police Force. It talks about its entire history, plus how it has been functioning, how there's pressure on soldiers, and how even rehabilitation of retired personnel is important. On page 12, you have government presented opposite positions, Supreme Court. So this is a policy statement which has come from the government, which endorsed permanent commission for SSC women officers in two sections. So the Supreme Court castigated the government for its stand on permanent commission, and favorably saw policy statement filed separately by the government as a letter on February 25, 2019. So it is not that the government's note and February 2019 policy statement clashed with each other. So the Supreme Court also wondered how the government had managed to present diametrically opposite positions in the court. So this issue is covered here. Then this is why delay appointments, asked Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has asked the government why it is holding back recommendations for appointments to various high courts even after reiteration by the collegium. So Attorney General blames collegium for taking a long time to forward files to government. So this continues allegations and counter allegations in judicial appointments. Then on page 13 you have FATF to review Pakistan's status today. So it actually will be news tomorrow, and we'll come to know what decision has been taken by FATF, the intergovernmental organization, international organization actually, FATF, Financial Action Task Force, which looks into money laundering and terror financing related cases at international level. So Pakistan has been grey listed by it, and it fears being blacklisted too or it may be coming out of grey list if FATF is satisfied with the steps, actions taken by Pakistan. So this will be news tomorrow. Then this is center gets Ladakh appoint non-gazetted personnel. So following shortage of personnel, Union government has empowered Union Territory of Ladakh to formulate its own rules to appoint non-gazetted officials. So their work is hampered and this is a step being taken. And here you have JNK to get delimitation commission. So about 6 months after state of Jammu and Kashmir was split into union territories of JNK Ladakh, government has moved to start the delimitation of assembly constituencies in Jammu and Kashmir. So the boundaries, delimitation commission, the commission decides the boundaries of constituencies. And this is no headway in India-US trade talks. So there are differences which have been narrowed down on 25 of the 30 issues now. But the differences continue and there is no headway that a mini trade deal may also be finalized while US President Donald Trump is on a visit to India. Then on international page, there is continuation of the old news about coronavirus, about Afghan deal which is expected to be finalized and announced, and regarding Syria, Pakistan as terror safe haven. So can skip this. Then on business page you have SEBI caps fees for investment advisors. So SEBI has okayed separation of advisory distribution to minimize conflict of interests. So with respect to investment advisors, now they would be having an advisory role for which there will be a cap on fees, and the distribution task has been separated out. So while regulator did not specify the upper limit of fees, consultation papers had proposed a cap on the fees at 2.5% of the assets under advice, or a fixed fee of 75,000 per year per family. So that will be announced soon. So also, individual investment advisors will not be able to provide distribution service. So this has been announced. Then this is response to long-term repo encouraging. So RBI had started with long-term repo to put in money in the banks so that further liquidity can be brought in the economy. So the response has been highly encouraging. It received total bids of 1.94 lakh crores for the 3-year repo, compared with notified amount of 25,000 crores. And here you have Moody's cuts India's GDP forecast, demand credit growth critical. So Moody's has revised its growth forecast for India downward to 5.4% for 2020 and 5.8% in 2021. Previous prediction was 6.6% and 6.7%. So now it has been downgraded. And below you have fiscal deficit target realistic. So Finance Minister said that fiscal deficit mentioned in the budget 2020-21 was absolutely realistic in terms of scope of revenue generation, scope of investments and projection for economic growth and consumption. So a lot of consultation preceded pragmatic budget is how she defends the budget, which has been highly criticized. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.